Hi there, and welcome back. We're going to continue our series on friction laws for fire sprinkler systems. Today, we're going to compare Darcy-Weisbach and Hazen-Williams methods directly. In this segment, we're going to explore two of the most common methods for calculating pressure loss in pipes. These two are the Darcy-Weisbach method and the Hazen-Williams method. We'll walk through a practical example using each method to see how they compare under the same circumstances. As we go through, I'll ask a few questions to get you thinking about which method might be best for different scenarios. So first, let's get some background. Ken Eisman is with the University of Maryland Fire Protection Group, and he wrote in the 5th edition of the SFPE handbook, the Darcy-Weisbach method is specifically required when designing large antifreeze systems. The reason for this is that antifreeze solutions can have significant changes in viscosity and density, especially in colder environments. These variations affect the flow and pressure in the system, and Darcy-Weisbach can account for them more accurately than other methods. For systems that use water only, the standard NFPA 13 does not mandate the use of Darcy-Weisbach because water maintains relatively stable properties, that would be density and viscosity, across temperatures typically encountered in fire protection. This stability means that the effects of turbulence on pressure loss are minor, and the simpler calculations using the Hazen-Williams method are often sufficient. But why not always use a more accurate method? Some might argue that using Darcy-Weisbach's method is unnecessarily complex for simple water-only systems, where the Hazen-Williams method is sufficient. After all, the Hazen-Williams method has been the industry standard for many years, and professionals are more familiar with it. Given this context, let's compare the Darcy-Weisbach and Hazen-Williams methods for the same scenario to better understand their differences and see how much effort each might require. So in this example, we're going to use a 4-inch pipe. So if we calculate that using the Hazen-Williams method, we would start by understanding that the flow for this example would be limited to about 500 gallons a minute. The pipe diameter in inches on the inside is 4.26 inches. The pipe length under consideration is 100 feet, and we're going to choose a roughness coefficient of 100. That roughness coefficient, 100, is typical of dry pipe systems. Now let's calculate the pressure loss using Hazen-Williams formula. The pressure loss, P, is equal to the quantity 4.52 times Q, the volume of water in this case going through the pipe, raised to the 1.85 power multiplied by the length of the pipe. That quantity is divided by the quantity representing the C factor raised to the 1.85 times the internal diameter, D, raised to the 4.87 power. If we plug the values for this example into that equation, we end up with P equals the quantity 4.52 times 500 raised to the 1.85 power times 100, that quantity, divided by the quantity 100 raised to the 1.85 power times 4.26 raised to the 4.87 power. If we calculate the numerator and denominator, we end up with P equals 444869.81 divided by 582.4045. And this gives an approximate pressure loss of 7.64 pounds per square inch gauge. Now let's calculate pressure loss using Darcy-Weisbach method. This method measures pressure loss in terms of feet of head. So the equation is H sub F equals F times ratio of the length of the pipe divided by its inner diameter times the velocity of the fluid in the pipe squared divided by twice the gravitational constant. In this example, we don't know the friction factor. The length of the pipe is 100 feet. The diameter of the pipe is taken as 4.26 inches divided by 12 inches, or 0.355 feet. Gravitational constant is 32.2 feet per second squared. We need to solve for the velocity of the water in terms of feet per second. So if we take the area of the pipe, pi times 0.355 divided by 2 squared, we get 0.099 square feet. The flow of water in the pipe at 500 gallons a minute is converted to cubic feet per second by multiplying the 500 gallons per minute by the reciprocal of 7.54 and then divide once again by 60 seconds per minute. That divided by the area that we just calculated, 0.99, gives 11.17 feet per second. Next, we can calculate the Reynolds number. The Reynolds number equals the velocity times the inner diameter of the pipe divided by the kinematic viscosity. So for this example, we're assuming water at 60 degrees and its kinematic viscosity is 1.208 times 10 to the minus 5. So let's plug in those numbers. 11.17 feet per second times 0.355, all divided by 1.208 times 10 to the minus 5, results in a Reynolds number of 3.282 times 10 to the fifth power. If we take that information and plug it into the James equation, we would then have calculated the friction factor for this pipe. The James equation is 0.25 divided by the log to the base 10 of the ratio between epsilon, the roughness, divided by 3.7 times the inner diameter of the pipe, plus 5.74 divided by the Reynolds number raised to the 0.9th power. All of that is squared. So a bit of an equation, but the result from that helps us define what's typically going on here. So the question is, what is the epsilon? What is the roughness? And inside of NFPA 13 from edition 2022, in the appendix, A28.2.4.8.2 gives an equivalency to the C factor of 100 with an epsilon of 0.015. And we're going to assume that because we're making that comparison with a wet pipe system. So if we take that ratio, epsilon divided by the inner diameter in inches, we get 0.015 divided by 4.26, which equals 0.003521. If we plug all of that into the James equation, we end up with a factor of 0.0279. Now we can calculate the pressure loss in terms of feet of head by plugging all that in. So H sub F is going to equal 0.0279 times the ratio of the length 100 feet divided by the inner diameter 0.355 times the velocity 11.17 squared divided by twice the gravitational constant. From that, we get an answer of 15.21 feet of head. So to make the comparison with what we arrived at with the Hazen-Williams equation, let's convert that to PSIG. And the easiest way to do that is simply multiply by 0.433, which gives us 6.59 PSIG. So in the end, let's make that comparison. The Hazen-Williams formulation gave us an answer of 7.64 pounds per square inch gauge. And this equation gave us 6.59 pounds per square inch gauge. The Darcy-Weisbach method, after correcting for velocity and the pipe roughness, gives a reasonable but lower pressure requirement. With realistic values, the two methods yield very similar results, but different. This shows that while the Darcy-Weisbach method is more versatile in terms of the fluids that might be flowing, it also deals with non-standard conditions regarding fire suppression systems. And these non-standard conditions might result from abnormal velocities, piping that is atypical, for instance, stainless steel, or unusual suppression media that, you know, these could include antifreeze systems, foams, or high-velocity fluids. I hope you've enjoyed this and followed the calculations. I am Ed Henderson. This is MeyerFire University.
This has been a preview of MeyerFire University. Join the next generation of fire protection experts at www.meyerfireuniversity.com.